From where? Out on the coast?
It looks like Texas. Probably in Texas, because that's where the Funk Brothers are from. And it was probably in Texas someplace. As you know, Dory Funk Jr. was a prominent wrestler, comes from a wrestling family.
One of the all-time greats.
Right. Dory Funk Sr., and this is Dory Funk Jr., and then he also has a brother, Terry Funk, and all well-recognized wrestlers in their own right.
Red, what do you account for your phenomenal success? What particular athletic skill, if in fact that was it, do you recognize as perhaps your greatest asset?
Well, I really don't know, Vince. I did start wrestling when I was very young. I started wrestling when I was 16 years old. And I guess I was better at wrestling than anything else, and so I just kept on wrestling and kept trying to improve my skills. And one thing about wrestling, you're always learning in wrestling, right up to the day you retire or you quit or you get hurt and injured and aren't unable to wrestle any longer. You're always learning, and you can learn from someone that's been in the business just a short period of time. You can always pick something up. Wrestling with Dory Jr., as you see, he is a ring general. You always got to be on your toes with guys of his caliber.
Well, here, outside, I mean, that's concrete that Red Bastien is, well, on, actually, in this unusual match, it appears to me that it falls count on the inside and the outside, and there, Red Bastien gets the Duke.
Got the Duke there. Well, here we go again. Now, this looks like must be a Texas death match because falls don't count, evidently. I know that once you get on top of Dory Jr., you got to stay on top. Because he's a man that's very resourceful, as the Lord says. When you get the upper hand, you just got to keep on trucking.
Well, unfortunately for Mr. Funk, I believe he has been busted open, perhaps from the outside of the ring. And right now, beautifully done. Nice suplex. And for the count. And there, Red Bastien, convincingly victorious.
Now he's got to answer the count. If he gets up before the count, why, we can still continue. Texas Deathmatch. I tell you, the Funk Brothers were always great at these matches. They were tough. It's very salty. Both Terry and Dory.
Well, you never could count them out, that's for sure. Never.
As a matter of fact, the father of the Funk Brothers actually died wrestling.
Is that right?
Yes, he was a gritty old beast, and he just loved to wrestle, and he was on his
ranch. What a maneuver we just saw.
Did you see that maneuver? That's why you say you can never count those Funk Brothers out, because they've always got a way to reach down and pull something up.
Incidentally, that's Ken Farber refereeing now. Good referee.
To the buckle again, and boy, I'll tell you, this has proven to be a tough matchup. I guess the two of you are perhaps never the same after this match. Ooh!
Ooh, good. Good height. Good height you got there.
This is the first time I've seen this. And evidently it's got to be around 8 or 10 years old. Funk wasn't going to allow that jump.
No, he was not going to allow that. Oh, wow, what a right hand. Oh, my. Toe-to-toe, my goodness, what a battle.
I think that headbutt hurt me as much as it did him.
Yeah.